Thank you very much, Cathaoirleach. Minister, earlier this evening, the Tánaiste had told us that he was ashamed to be a member of this Dáil. Now, looking around this convention centre, I'm a little ashamed to be a member of this Dáil too, but for very different reasons. I think we set an appalling example by decamping from Dáil Éireann down here to this glass palace, and we're told that it's so that we can be safe. But while we do that, and I know that the cost is sometimes exaggerated, somebody told me tonight it only costs around 30,000 euros a day, but how much could that do for children in our schools, and in particular for special needs students? Now, Minister, I appreciate that you're not terribly long in the job, and I appreciate that you've made a series of announcements, and there are all sorts of works going to be carried out in schools right across Ireland. But when? Schools are opening in less than 4 weeks' time. And schools have been refused money when they applied in good time to carry out works to your department. Now, I appreciate you weren't the minister at the time. It was a different minister for education. But, you know, the role of Minister for Education continues, and this is effectively the same as the last government. There are no policy changes. There is no change of direction. It's a continuum, unfortunately, as has been made very clear. So what I want to know from you, Minister, is when are these works going to be carried out? And are they going to be carried out in time for children to go back to school? And in particular, I want to know what is going to be done in respect of SNAs who have to engage intensively with children with special needs, who are not in a position. I appreciate that you've met with the teaching unions, and I appreciate that you're meeting with the union that represents SNAs. But what specifically is going to be done in respect of those SNAs who have to engage intimately with students? Because it's simply not good enough if those students cannot go back to work in this republic represented by this Dáil, which looks after itself so well and does so little for SNA students. SNAs and the students upon whom they depend for care.
I'm not going to talk to Antara.
Thank you, Cathaoirleach. In the first instance, Deputy, as regards the decision to operate from this building, you will be well aware and you will appreciate it is not my decision, it's the decision of, I assume, the business committee, but I think that's a matter you would have to take up elsewhere. It's beyond my remit. In relation to the works being carried out and being carried out in time in the schools and indeed being resourced, and you make reference to the fact that many of the schools have previously applied to the department for very necessary, indeed emergency works at times, minor works or whatever the case might be, and indeed have been refused funding. I'm very pleased to confirm to you, Deputy, that the money for the works to be carried out in the next number of weeks will be arriving in the schools next week. And the money, not just for the works, but the money for the additional aid or the individual who will help within the school for the month of August to prepare the school with the support, obviously, of management within the school, will also be arriving in the school. So there is an absolute commitment that the funding and the works that need to be done will be resourced. And as a show of good faith for that, it will arrive, before the end of next week. Also, just to say to you, in relation to the time frame for it, this minor works grant is a very familiar system within the primary school system already. They're very well used to operating it. They know what's involved in it. And already, even before any announcement was made, I know principals and deputy principals and managers within school knew exactly where that money had to be spent. And likewise, that even though it's a new form of funding for second level schools, equally so, they know exactly what needs to be done. And I would have to say to you, Deputy, I have been hugely heartened by the videos that I have seen, by the messages that have come in from principals who are just getting down to doing the work and making the adjustments and the arrangements that need to be put in place. And indeed, I'm sure many, you yourself have seen many of these on social media, very positive, very proactive, very worthwhile engagement from all involved in the school sector, just so keen to reopen the schools safely and indeed to reopen them well.
Yeah, but my question- is, will they have to tender for the works? Because if they're going to have to tender, it simply won't be carried out in time. And I've one very brief question. In respect of students who are doing their Leaving Cert, who are hoping to go to university in the United Kingdom, will anything be done to ensure they have results in time to take up places in the United Kingdom?
Indeed. Could I say to you that the Leaving Cert results are in time for UCAS? The Leaving Cert results come out on the 7th of September, fully in time for UCAS, and there has been engagement in relation to that. And indeed, just on the wider issue of students taking up positions, as many of them do tend to travel to other European third level institutions, we've had very positive engagements. I have written to my counterparts throughout Europe in relation to students having the opportunity to take up positions and asking them to adopt a flexible approach. And we've had very positive engagement. And indeed, we have heard from the Netherlands recently that they have written to all their institutions and have advised for a similar flexibility. So I think that's very positive. In relation to the schools, the works, it depends on the body of work that will be done within the schools. There will be very small jobs, there will be bigger jobs, there will be, it is, as it says, minor work. So the schools will know themselves what will be involved in each case on a case-by-case basis.